So if a film maker or a director has to come to you with a script, so what are the major things that you look for in a good script?
So, see, for me, if I have to like something, I think I like it instantly. Instantaneously, I have to like the script. And I think more importantly, when I say like the script means, A, it has to appeal to my sensibilities, whatever genre that I'm listening to or I'm trying to attempt. But there's something, which is, for me, that the characters in that script, they need to have a, I mean, their journey has to excite me because I'm a small town guy like most of us, and I think characters have been very important for me right from childhood. How does a character move forward? What's the trajectory, and how does a character end up triumphing? So the triumph of the human spirit is again very important. Something that I think very well is shown in Torbaz, my latest film, which fortunately is doing very well on Netflix. It's been trending at number one position for more than a week in a whole lot of countries. So I think Sanjay Dutt's character in the film, for me, epitomizes the triumph of the human spirit. So apart from the, I'm not very plot driven. I'm more character driven, I think. And that is why I often I've shared this a whole lot with my filmmaker friends, with my director friends, with my friends from the media that I grew up in Chandigarh, and my late father was a bureaucrat, and we were simple middle class family. But I would but I think my late father would ensure that he took us to, I mean, all his sons, we three brothers, all of us to the cinema regularly, and that's where I saw my the Sholes and Choti Si Baat and Ma and all those big plus blockbuster movies. And only thing I knew was that when I entered the cinema as a small kid, I was like watching films like this, and I remembered and I came back. So it definitely left an impact on me. So I would say that more than like these films, it's life that has really worked for me. So I would say that rather than more to do with visuals, I think it's, I'm definitely a product of life, like a whole lot of us. And that I think really helps me to choose my scripts, work with the people I want to. I've been very fortunate to have worked with, all the actors I have worked with, all the directors I've worked with, all the technicians. And with a whole lot of humility and gratitude, I think I'm thankful that having worked with such senior people and such big names, I've never ever had any problems so far, and I'm sort of liked, or at least that's what I'm made to believe.
So we see a lot of producers these days. Everybody has their own genre and their own interest. Like you said, you make films in a particular genre and you are character driven. When a filmmaker has to come to you or he comes to you with a script, does it help that he comes up to you as a with a film project or just with a script? Because as a producer, would you like to start with a script or maybe a project where he has already made the whole
Sure,
project, the actors as well?
sure. I think I missed that part. Sorry, in your last question, with you were aiming to ask me the same. For me, after this, after the, like I said, the trajectory of the character, what works for me is that the germ of marketing, or the if it has to appeal to me, it appeals to me like that. Whatever, it can be any genre. I'll give a small example. If when like Sai Biwi or Gangster, my first film, when people would ask me that day, what are you? So I believe you're making a film. What is it called? What is it about? So I would just say Sai Biwi or Gangster, and people would say, oh, okay, wow. I think the title itself specified what we were trying to make. It was an ode to Sai Biwi or Ghulam. I did not have to specify that. I did not have to specify that society is changing, and cinema changes along with the society, and it definitely is a reflection of society. And if today Sai Biwi or Ghulam were to be made, then how would the Sai be? How would the Biwi be? And how would the Ghulam be? That was the film all about. But I did not have to speak this two, three, four, five lines. Sai Biwi or Gangster was enough. So for me, either the title or the one-liner has to be. So what is Torbaz? Torbaz at Suicide Bomber Kids and how Sanjay Dutt changes their life through cricket. It's simple. I mean, I listen to scripts also like that. After listening to that half an hour, 1 hour, 5 minutes, 2 minutes, 4 hours, I don't know. But it has to sum up in my mind like this, the way I'm telling you. It has to be very clear to me that what are we attempting? What is the... See, I'm not here to give messages to people or to society or to reform anybody. I'm just following my passion. And I want to make films essentially something that I would enjoy making and watching them. And I just... Every film, I hope that I make movies that audiences enjoy. But to sum it up, it has to be... The message has to be... The message to me has to be very clear that what is that one-liner that has to appeal to me? Then it has to have, like I said, the character or the character's journey. And I need to see how well they're traveling and how far is also not important. It's not important how long you live. It's important how well you live. So for me, that is important. You know, how well has that character lived in that world, which I'm trying to create through my films? And it has to have a germ of marketing that if I'm so that if whenever I'm selling that film or I'm that film is available to the audiences, what is the, you know, what would be my USP in terms of offering? I think these two, three things are good enough to make up my mind. And then, of course, the screenplay and all those nitty gritties come later on. That can be changed. You can have another sitting with your writers, you know, you can try and rework dialogue, so you can music and songs, all that comes later. But primarily, it is all these things that I've just shared with you.
As a producer, how do you scale up a small project? I mean, people don't have, you know, they don't know how to scale up their project so that it becomes big. Maybe you add actors to that. Maybe you make a different kind of a story. Maybe you make a story which appeals to international audience. How do you scale up your project?
See, for me, scalability it depends. When I say small project, even if you're making a movie for cinema hall, say even hypothetically in 1 rupee, it still costs 4 crore rupees because that is your minimum print and advertising cost to release the movie. So even with a film with zero budget will be 4 crores. That's point number one. So there's nothing small according to me. But having said that, yeah, I think the most important thing is the writing, because for me, writing is very, very important. Or at least, see, often there is a mismatch between the writing and how it's portrayed. You know, how the final product takes, because there are, like certain novels we read, we find them very interesting, and then we see the adapted versions, the adaptations. We say, oh my God, the book was better. So similarly, at times the scripts come, you know, look nice, etc. But if it's a well-written film, and when I say well-written, it's good scenes, etc. If you're enjoying reading it, and then you have a good filmmaker who can just transform that, I think mostly you have done your bit. But like I said, scaling up the right casting, getting somebody in one... could be a character which nobody thinks that, you know, oh my God, how will this person, how can, like, for instance, in Sai Weaver Gangster, suddenly the gangster keeps on changing. And we've just gone up and up and up. In terms of scalability, I'm saying, or in terms of, you know, the actors. So casting definitely is very important. Writing is very important. And see, perception is like the tree. But you know, there's the tree and there's the shadow, but the shadow over there is actually the perception and the tree is the character. So if you don't have character, I can give big statements now, you know, Rahul Mitra's next on this come and it'll be published. But what I'm saying is if I don't have the content to match up to it, then all that scalability goes, because you cannot fool the audience today. They are so intelligent, they can bust you like this. So I have never tried to unnecessarily go and create a perception which the film is not about. I rather tell the world what I'm making rather than lying about it or saying, you know, that, oh my God, watch my film. And it'll be, you never find my interviews like that. I will always be talking in terms of either the journey of the character or the film or the world it is in. And I think, like I said, a good movie, the audiences can smell it. And this scalability, of course, you know, if like the idea is small, you can scale it up by way of budget. But the budget has to be justified by an actor. So Torbas could not have been made in this particular budget that we made the movie in if the star cast would not have been this, you know. So the moment Sanjay Dutt came on the project, then it was of a particular size and a particular scale. So scalability, so casting comes handy here. So I think it's a mix and match of a whole lot of issues. But like I said, there is a good movie, there's a bad. All the time we attempt to make a good movie, at times it works, at times it doesn't. But more importantly, I think cinema is just the celebration of the human mind. And that is what it should be to all of us. And that's how I take cinema.